And so, without further ado, I'd like to welcome up speaker number one, Mehak Khela from London, Ontario, who will be speaking to us today on working in agriculture. Is it more than just farming?
An industry that feeds us is an industry worth fighting for. Friends, families, fellow contestants, and judges, today I will be presenting to you a topic I am very passionate about, how working in agriculture is more than just farming. I have participated actively in Environmental Defense Canada and several other agricultural and environmental projects. When someone says they work in agriculture, the image that pops up in our minds is most likely someone on a farm, harvesting crops, feeding livestock, or something along those lines. But what we don't see is what's happening behind the scenes. Though farming is a major pillar of agriculture, it is made up of a lot more. Agriculture affects our lives on a daily basis through advanced technology, scientific research, and education. Agriculture is a huge contributor to Canada and many other countries' economies. It provides jobs to over 2.3 million Canadians and 29.4 million jobs to the total population of the world. The agriculture industry also contributes over $110 million annually to Canada's GDP. However, the members of the agriculture community are slowly decreasing as the days go on. Agriculture traces back to about 9,500 BC. And if we look back to when agriculture started, we can see there are a lot of processes and discoveries involved. Agriculture started with domestication, making plants and animals dependent on humans and their environment. After that came extracting resources from the environment for food, medicine, building materials, and more. Now we made it to where we are today. I was born and raised in urban cities, but my family comes from a long line of farmers. My great-grandparents and my grandparents were all farmers, and I still have a few aunts and uncles who are pursuing this. From all these generations, there's a lot of technology that is made to keep developing the agriculture industry. My grandfather once told me a story about when his friend went to England and saw that they were pumping water out of the ground using a motor instead of doing it manually through a well. At the time, this was a huge deal, but now look at where technology has come today. Agriculture started from the Homo habilis with their basic stone tools. After that came traditional shovels and hand plows. Eventually came walking plows, grain drills, and mowing machines. These tools all seem very silly and simple compared to the technology we have today. Tractors, plowing machines, and other manual machines are also becoming more outdated as we speak. Machinery like the FarmBot, a robot that can plant and water seeds, and remote-controlled tractors are agriculture's newest generation. Moisture sensors are embedded into almonds to help save and regulate the water that is used to keep those nuts alive. There is no other technology out there that is as unique as agricultural technology. As you can see, technology plays a huge role in agriculture. Another way agriculture is more than working on a farm is education. Agriculture education is becoming more and more important as the days go on. Going to a school about agriculture teaches one a multitude of subjects, from horticulture, land management, health and nutrition, machine classes, and several other related subjects. A lot of people think agriculture might be useless, old, and unprofessional, but when they hear about things like agricultural science, it suddenly seems a lot more important. Not a lot of people really know what agriculture is made up of unless they look into it. Getting an agriculture degree can land someone a lot of jobs. For example, landscaping, farm accounting, soil scientists, plant biologists, and several more jobs. Agriculture education may not seem very helpful, but now we know that it really is. Agriculture is a set of activities that alters the environment to engender plants and animals for human use. Let's use clothing for an example. The first step is productions. Farmers must produce the correct crops and raise animals accordingly to satisfy their goal, which in this case is making a shirt. And in order to fulfill this, they must grow cotton and sheep would produce wool. After this is processing. The raw materials will now turn into a shirt. However, this does not magically happen. The raw materials the cotton and wool will now turn into thread, and the thread will be used to make cloth, which will eventually turn into a shirt. Working to make these raw materials into tangible items and items that consumers need is a great skill that people that work in agriculture are very familiar with. As you can see, these individuals aren't your stereotypical farmer, but are much, much more. Working in agriculture uses a lot of skills and techniques in order to be precise and grow quality animals and plants. Someone that is involved in agriculture must know about climate change, soil erosion, and other environmental issues. They need to be adaptable. They need to know what consumers demand in order to be successful and change out what sort of crops they grow every once in a while. Working in agriculture also means one must be updated on latest technologies, knowing about new pesticides, new methods of cultivation, harvesting, storage, and transport are all very crucial when working in agriculture. Agriculture gives us a sense of community. Where I live, there's this really big park that had a barn and a small community gardens where kids would come with their parents and learn about animals and how to grow vegetables. This was done in a community setting, which brought people together and taught them how their food and essentials got to them and how much work was put into it. From your home garden to a 100-acre field, agriculture surrounds us every day. It is a part of our lives, whether we realize it or not. From our clothing and homes to our education and our future, agriculture is a part of our lives. Without it, we wouldn't be where we are today. Everything we have now is because of agriculture. Therefore, agriculture is more than just working on a farm. And to those that work in acres and not hours, we thank you.